Welcome back to Gundar Tutorials. Today we will build a medieval bakery. So it features, of course, a few ovens, which are in front of here. Combination of campfire, and then we have some item frames with bread in it. And of course also a bit of wood to get those ovens fired up. And the house itself, well, it has part living room, part bakery. The bakery part will be like in the lower floor, and over here could be some storage area where you could put your floor, for example. So enough talked, now let's see how to build it. So let's start with the fundament. We first build a main house, and afterwards we'll build the front of it, so to say the ovens. So we start in the lower left corner with dark oak log, and this is the corner here. Then we have a distance of 5 in between, and then another distance of 5 in between, which is basically the front. Then we can turn around, then we have a distance of 2 times 3. Turning again around here in the back, we don't mirror the front, but have now a distance of 3, 3, and another time 3. And then, of course, around turning and closing up the fundament. So it's quadratic, so no big surprises here. That's the shape. Now, for the first floor, we increase each of these oak log places to a height of 4, like this, and connect them. So it's a quite straightforward build. Don't get confused here in the back side, because you have now a different shape than the front. It's just now 3 instead of 5, so just increase the height to 4, and then connect those timbers. So on this left side here, we have a bit of an extension going on. And for that, we place one block below the first floor, two timber blocks, and then we build some supporting element beneath it, like in this way. This is of course done at each of these positions, also here in the middle. And this is kind of the storage area which we saw earlier in the video. So then we connect them also here, and this is basically the shape of the crown floor. For the walls, we use strip birch log, so we don't close up this area here because it's like being open so that fresh air can come in and probably dry out any leftover watery consistency. And then we just build these. Maybe we can use the strip birch wood. Helps also. And then we just surround this area. Here in the middle, then we can just build two more timber blocks. And this is basically done all the way around. Here will be then the entrance area. Here, of course, could be then windows. So it's quite similar to what we know and what we like. So let's speed this up a bit. Okay, perfect. So as mentioned, we don't close up this area. This will be done later. Let's move on to the first roof. So this one is a bit tricky, so stay with me. First of all, we extend this row with one more block. And then we start right away the roof. 3 staircases right next to each other. Then a second row also with 3 staircases right next to each other. Then we have these supporting elements, and a combination of planks and staircases as you know it. So we mirror this exactly on the other side here. So we have two rows with 3 staircases. Then we have the supporting elements and place some plank and a staircase on top of it. So now for the interior part, we built a shape like this. So we have a height of 2 here, and are 2 blocks from the center here. And we close it off with a pyramid shaped like structure. So now it gets a bit more tricky. So what I did is that I replaced now this staircase with a corner one. Then I had also this lower one changed to this staircase combination. And then I placed here an upside down one. And on top of it, we just placed normal rows of staircases, like so. Of course, we do this exactly the same on the other side. So we have to place two corner pieces like this. And then we can place normal staircases as you would think of. And here's one upside down version of it. So now we can close up this roof. Means we can extend the plank by one and then build a few more staircases. And that's already the first part of the storage roof. Now we move on with the side here and build these small extensions to the back and the front. For that, we place just a single block on each of these middle segments. And we do this exactly the same on the back side, like this. So we have here a distance of 5 in between. So now we can increase the height of each of these blocks up to a height of 4. And we can connect them like this. We can also connect the lower row so that we have basically a border or frame with a made out of timber blocks. Of course, on the back side is the very same. So we build here the frame, connect all of them to each other, and let it be a day. Okay, and then also one connection on top of it. So now we go forward to the next roof. For this roof, we destroy this corner here, this corner block again, and start the roof one height point lower than what you think. And then we have this two staircases going up. Of course, we do this the same on the other side. And basically have now three rows out of staircases. Then we can build here in the middle part again, supporting elements, and then we change to a plank staircase combination. So it looks like this. Of course, again, on the back side, the same. So we destroy this corner block again, place a few staircases down, three in a row. Here, the very same. And then in the middle, we make a more of these supporting elements. Okay, and that's already part of this middle roof which is going on. Now, regarding the middle roof, we first extend the ground floor up to the first floor. So we basically place on each of these corner points lock blocks, increase them to a height of 4. And then we can also connect them. Here at the back side, it's already basically done. And on this side, you can just do what you see. So this is the extension upwards, and here we just continue our build. Of course, this is the last segment to close it off. And yes, I also did connect here the inner row with lock blocks because it looked then a bit nicer from the inside. Now for the main roof, we have first, of course, we take dark oak stairs and place them down the first row. Then we have a second row with staircases. You can always connect them here. And on the back side, we do the very same. So we have two rows of staircases like here. Okay, then we start with a bigger height increase. So we now continue with a combination of planks and staircases. So let me first show you how the shape will be done. And now we iterate between building these staircases and these supporting elements. The aim is to have it like two times. So we have two times staircases, then two times a plank and a staircase. And on the top of it, we have a even bigger inclinement. So now let's finish this up. And yes, on top of it, we place then two planks, and on top of it, a staircase. So this is basically the shape of the, well, main roof. So now we can move to the other side here to also build this very same shape. So we have here a staircase, two rows of it, on the back side too. So no surprises here. And then we basically mirror the other side. So now we have two rows with a plank and a staircase. And the final one has a height of 3. So yes, planks on these positions. Oops. Here two planks. Planks, planks, and on top of it staircases to finish that part of the roof. And now it's basically just filling up the interior. So let me speed that up. Perfect. So we basically have now the basic shape of the bakery. And now it's, well, I guess the next part would be to build here a few walls. So yeah, basically we take the same strip birch wood as before and make it frame-like around the walls. And then it's really up to you on how to choose the shape. So you could build windows, you could build bigger windows, you could build smaller windows. It's basically up to you. I have chosen then big windows here, and here also windows with a height of 2. On these sections, you can also decide if you want to build it like on the inward frame, or if you want to move it one to the outside. It should look by both ways. Good. Okay, then here the walls, then we have also to close up these two points. And we might now get rid of these elements here and also this middle timber because we don't need them. So for the upper part, the wall, we just build a surrounding element. So it's not much going on here. On this side and on the other side, just build a surrounding and then you could put it in some classes, whatever you like. Okay, perfect. Let's move on to the framing. For the frame and to give it this special dark medieval touch, we use staircases and not cracked staircases, but cobblestones. And what we do is that we surround each of these roof tiles with a row of, well, cobblestone staircases. So we start with this one here. Just extend the rows where staircases are with a staircase. Don't forget that this one here is an upside down. So we have to mimic that. And that's already the framing. Now we can do this for each of these sides. So we increase it here also. The row with a staircase out made out of cobblestone, and on the side, 2. And the upper one, well, you guessed it correctly, is done the same way. So, and over here, 2. staircase, full blocks, just extended by one, as you would think of. And that's basically the framing. Now to finish it off, we place upside down staircases like on these positions here. The same is done on the side here. Basically just finish these rows off. It's just an extra, you don't have to do that, but yeah, I guess it looks quite nice. Here for the final row, we just place another row of staircases down to close this part of the roof up and to have that one finished. So now for the top part of the roof, we use then, we first could build a row of blocks so that we have it easier now by placing cobblestone stairs, which are going to face each other. So it looks like this in the end. And this is basically the frame for the one side. And I guess you guessed it right. We do this for the other positions as well. So let me speed that up a bit, because it's basically always extending each row which you have here by the respective version in cobblestone. And for the top parts, we always build first the row of with locks, then one upside down staircase, and then a normal one, and then we iterate between the two facings. This is done on the front as well as on the back side. Oh, I forgot here the framing. Damn. Let's hurry and build this too. Okay, perfect. Placing the upside down staircases also. And then we can build the locks and close off the roof here. Okay, perfect. Now we have to do this, of course, on the top too. So one long row of lock blocks. And then a staircase, and then we iterate between forth and back. Of course, don't forget that due to the size of the house, we don't get an even out iteration between forth and back. So what I mean is, by doing this here, you end up with an arrow in the middle part. So we first have to find the middle part, which is right here. And there we can place a normal slab, and then we are good too. As a small bonus, I added here also some balcony, which I basically just did by placing down here two blocks, which go to the front, and then connecting them, placing one upside down version here and here. Like that, then yeah, just throw down some fancy like some maybe slab so that your little people don't fall through. And then I also built some sun protection. I've done that by using either dark oak fences or a dark oak trapdoor, which is facing upwards. And then you can take, for example, any car that you like. Let's choose the red one. And then you have to press shift, of course, and you are able to place them all the way through. So it looks like this little sun protection thingy, which you see often. So now let's move on to the ovens, because, well, without it, a bakery would not much be a bakery, right? Now, it really doesn't matter where you place them. Maybe anywhere in front of your house is good. So what I did to build them, I have used stone bricks and cobblestone, and it's done by placing here two rows with a bit of two. Then we have on the side another bug that has the single one, and we place a staircase on top of it. Here, the back part, we use this same with cobblestone. Then here in the front, two full stone bricks again, and we place a staircase on top of it. This is done here as well as here. And here on the back side, we have a cobblestone staircase on this position. Now I closed it off by placing here a upside down staircase and a slab version of it on top of it. So now that we have this smoking effect, I use a campfire, which I place like in this position. And then you already got a lot of smoke, which is quite cool because, well, it's still an oven, so it should generate any smoke. And to make it a bit more realistic, I also shut it off with an iron trapdoor, which hinders some of the smoke to come through, but not all of it. It's still going on. But now it looks like it's also safe against any rain. And then in the inside, of course, I ripped out the floor, replaced it with bricks here, and placed then also campfires on the ground. Now I used then some trapdoors, which I placed over it. Item frames, where are they here? And some bread. And if you also crouch, you can then place these item frames on top of the trapdoors, and then you can put in some of the bread. And so it looks like you're actually baking here something. And that's the little oven which my bakery has. I built two of them, one right next to the other. You can basically build as many as we like, but of course it's only makes sense to have a few of them. Now maybe a few more styling tips. I also added a chimney to the roof. This can be done wherever you like, of course. Then I added also some wood stack in front of the house, made out of this acacia wood, just placing it down, basically. And I surrounded it with a fence. Where is it? For example, this one, and then just some slab over it. So it looks like a small roof, which protects the wood from getting wet. Of course, you can build it also asymmetric like this. And what else did I do? For the surrounding of the storage area, I used then mainly fences, because I don't like to use here glass, because that's also realistic. And also here you could, for the storage window, use, for example, fences. You could also make here a door for easy access, but that's also up to you. So, I guess we are finished now with this tutorial. I hope you liked it, and as always, if so, then please leave a comment, leave a like, and then see you in the next one. Ciao!